and he saw a face of three huge indeterminate spots on white and a pale pansy flower. He was struck violently in the chest, pulled back, and the door slammed in his face and locked. Griffin had unpacked his crates and boxes and spread his bottles of all sizes all over the place, on the table and the floor. And when Mrs. Hall pointed to the mess he had created, he suggested the compensation could be charged in his bill.
Oh my God! Oh my God! What a mess! You are spoiling the place!
Don't worry. You can charge me a fee each time you find such a mess. The stranger worked very simply. On other times, he would rise late and while away his time, be seen in the room, sitting audibly and sleeping in the arch by the fire. He communicated with none and rarely went abroad by daylight. At twilight, he would go out muffled up invisibly and appear suddenly to be a scare to men and children. When people talked about him, Mrs. Hall explained him as an experimental investigator, while others suspected him to be a criminal trying to escape from justice. Yet others felt that he was rather a harmless lunatic. Later, some supernatural stories were also floated. When the word reached the village general practitioner, thus, that the stranger possessed 1,001 bottles of rare chemical, he felt jealous of the stranger and went to interview him.
I've heard you take an interest in scientific things. You're raising funds for the village nurse. Would you subscribe?
I'd consider it.
Are you researching?
I am.
A long research?
A long research.
Oh, you must have been given permission. Most valuable prescription.
Yes.
Is it medical?
Thank you. What are you fishing after?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hurt you.
Look, here it is. I read it. 5 ingredients. Put it down.
There was a prescription burning, wasn't it? How the devil can you move an empty sleeve like that?
Empty sleeve?
Yes, an empty sleeve.
It's an empty sleeve, is it? You saw it was an empty sleeve. Are you sure? Think again. After this strange experience, Gus was not in a condition to stay there any further. He rushed straight to the vicarage, where the village vicar, Bunting, lived. When he narrated the entire story, and something from the sleeve pinched his nose, as if between the thumb and the forefinger, the vicar laughed heartily and called it a very strange story. It was not easy to convince anyone